Good morning, YouTube. So this is my Tracer 4215 charge controller, and just this morning I've connected it to my 4S lithium ion battery bank here, and we're charging away. Let's see, I'll get it down onto lithium ion there, 15.27 volts. Yeah, we've got about 20 to 30 millivolts between the highest and lowest, pack 1 and 2, or group 1 and 2, I guess. So yeah, I've been running this all morning. So what I've got here is just a temporary cable run over here to charge the one battery pack. We'll cut over to a computer screen shot of the solar charge controller monitoring program. And I can show you how I have this set up, because right now I've got the Wi-Fi box plugged in so I can monitor the battery from my main PC.
Okay, YouTube, here we are on the EPEver solar monitoring program, and I've got my Tracer 4215BN, and I've got that set up over the E-Box Wi-Fi transmitter there. And let's see, so this down below here is what we've been doing today. I started out pretty early this morning, a little before 7 a.m., and I turned on my DC load. If we switch over here, you can see here's the voltage. It dropped down into the low 12-volt range. But anyway, I ran that for a while, and the voltage was getting a little low, so I actually shut off my dump load until the solar power came up. Oh, it was about 8:30 or 8:40 this morning that the sun hit the panels, because there's some trees off to the east that block the sun until around then. And then since then, we've been supplying about 100 and, let's see, what's the load power? 147 watts here right now. That's the blue line. And then here's the solar, and we're up to 243 watts right now. And let me show you the battery parameters here. I'll just read that from the controller. So I've got a user defined charging voltage, and I've got 33 amp hours, which is about my battery pack capacity. And then I've set up the voltages here. I may need to adjust these a little bit. I don't quite know how all of these relate, but I've got maximum charging voltage of 16 volts, or 4 volts per cell, 4 cells in series, shut off at 12 volts, or low voltage disconnect here. I have the equalization and boost at 16 volts, and then I have the float at 15.9. So I want to see how those work over the course of the day. But yeah, it's coming up voltage wise. We're in boost charge mode. And yeah, it looks like everything's working. So it is possible to run a 4S 16 volt battery off of one of these. I think they say the user mode voltage will go up to 17. So you could actually run all the way up to 16.8 volts, which is 4.2 volts per cell. I'm just running up to 16 volts, which I think my inverter will handle. So here's the real-time current. So this morning I was pulling about 10 amps out of the battery for probably 45 minutes. And then here's where the green is the battery. When I turned it on again, it was pulling a couple of amps, and then gradually it's been charging now. So yeah, this is the second day I've had the battery pack on the solar charge controller, and I changed some of the voltages around. Probably not quite there yet, but I did manage to get the battery charged up here. You can see here's the green is the battery current. I wasn't able to fully charge it yesterday, so today it got up here under boost charge, and then I got it to finally taper off, where now it's down pretty near 0 amps. You can see we're charging at 300 milliamps right now. I've got the charge voltage set to 16.1. I may actually drop that down to 16. I was just playing around with maximum cutoff settings, and actually that's what I programmed in there, and it's actually doing that. So I think tomorrow I'll try 16 volts. Yeah, so I have it set, I believe, for 120 minutes in boost charge, and then it switched over to float. I have the float and the boost voltage are both set to 16.1. I think if I do boost at 16.1 and then float at 16, float voltage has very low current. I was noticing there's about 100 millivolts of drop in the battery wiring and my fuse, so that's why I set this originally to 16.1. But yeah, looks like I have a few little changes to do here. Got it to go into float charge, so at least that particular setting is working right. Yeah, so far looking pretty good. I'll have to try changing some of these parameters again. That's the only way you can really tell what's going on. You can set the numbers, but then you have to see how the system reacts and what it does there. I think the first day I just didn't get the battery fully charged, and now my state of charge is showing 100%. So I guess when it goes into what it considers float charge, that's when it's up at 100%. Anyway, I think we've got a semi-working set of parameters here. I want to make a few more changes tonight and let it go over another day, and especially now that I've got the battery fully charged and my battery monitor shows that it's everything's up to 16 volts or 4 volts per cell. So we're good on the charge. So now I want to actually try discharging it, because towards the end of the day, the way my system is set up, the solar panel output will be below the load power. So at the end of the day, it'll actually discharge the battery a little bit. And then tomorrow at the beginning of the day, it'll discharge the battery some more, which basically empties the battery and then makes room for the charge during the day. And then that way I don't run into this situation where the solar panel output is truncated, because the idea is I want to empty the battery here before the sun comes up to make room for charge during the middle of the day. But the first day I didn't get the battery fully charged, so the second day I wanted to make sure there, so I kind of waited here until the battery was starting to charge. So I finally got the battery charged here, and now it's been pretty much in float charge for an hour or two. But yeah, making progress on this, so I think one more day and I'll try a few more adjustments here. Trying to get all the parameters. There's 14 charging parameters in this charge controller, so it's pretty complicated to get them all working together and consistent, and some of them aren't documented very well, so you don't really know what they do until you change one and then see what happens. Anyway, cruising along here. I'll let this finish up today, and then we'll see what it looks like tomorrow. So I'll catch you then.